Tonight on Love Island, Brendan's dreams come true.
You must choose which twin you want to keep, either you must send back to the resort. Here we go.
Eve adores Brendan. We wanted him to make the right decision.
Emma, Eve.
It's called the Love Shack. It's not called the Best Friend Shack.
But it's Sophie's worst nightmare.
So we know who she's picking. I have no rights on him. Maybe she's done me a favour.
Now, can she face the truth?
10 stone.
F***ing irresponsible.
I was told that I was too fat.
Welcome to Love Island, where last night you decided it took three to tango and sent the twins, Eve and Emma, into the Love Shack with Brendan.
But as we all know, three is a crowd, and no horny ballroom dancer in his right mind would ever want a three in a bed with two sisters, no. So I'm afraid one of them would have to sit this dance out.
Yep, yes. Which left our Brendan facing a twin dilemma. Mm. Which of them did he fancy? Which of them fancied him?
But most importantly of all, which one was up for it?
Go for it. That's
I've got to go.
Love Shack. Go.
Help. Holy shit, I'm going to the Love Shack. Boy is in the Love Shack. Oh, far out. Now that is love all over.
Because Crystal Stevens said, no, but it's her that fancies him. And I went, no, it's not. It's
That's
not
what Sophie
me.
Said. She went to me, she went, oh, I went, no, it's her.
So he's not going to know, and then if he chooses you, it blatantly means he doesn't like me, he doesn't want to be in there, right?
No, it doesn't.
It does. It does. It does, because he doesn't want that connection. It's called the Love Shack. It's not called the Best Friend Shack. Do you know what I mean?
Me and Emma had both had individual conversations with people, and no one knew which one. Everyone kept getting it wrong. So that panicked me even more, because I'm like, well, if they don't know, how is Brendan going to know?
You're the one that has a crush on him, right?
No, see? See, everyone said that, so he's going to choose Emma if one of us go in. Did you think that because of how I'm acting, or did you think that because...
You told me.
No, Eve.
Oh, it was you?
Yeah.
See, it's confusing.
Yeah. And Crystal said the same. Crystal said, no, it's your sister that likes him. I went, no, it's me.
I did find myself getting a little bit tearful because I did get worried then because I was like, this is the first time I'm worried that someone likes Emma.
Oh, my God. 2 for the price of 1.
You're a lucky boy.
Come on in.
Hey, it's good,
That's
isn't
amazing,
it?
Man. It's really
Oh, my
nice.
God. Did you expect it to be... One of the new girls and not two of the new girls, or, I mean, you know...
I can't expect it to be one of you.
Yeah.
I didn't know which one. It's kind of cool. First of all, just being voted into the Love Shack is really nice. I'm very excited to have had that privilege. And then to get twins is just... It's kind of cool. I'm excited about it. Because, you know, one-on-one can be quite intense and you have to find conversation all the time. But when there's three, man, it's a whole new dynamic.
That's the difference.
Brendan, do you know the difference between us? Who's Emma and who's Eve?
You're Emma, she's Eve.
Cool. I feel like... he said he was happy, didn't he? He said he was happy that we were both in here. So it's got to mean something.
Dear Brendan, 2's company, 3's a crowd, so you must choose which twin you want to keep. The others, either you must send back to the resort. Please go back to the Love Shack and tell the twins who is staying and who is going.
I felt more relaxed the minute I walked in here.
You did?
I really did. You did. And I just kept looking like this, thinking he'll think I'm the one that's been looking up.
Then he'll go, I want the one that's been looking away.
Oh, we can't win him.
I know.
The vibe I get from one of them is more than the other. I'll give you a chance. Oh, well.
You two are the more suited ones anyway, but we might be too similar.
I want to choose Emma, but I think I'm going to choose Eve. Because I've been led to believe, and I get a slight feeling that Eve likes me a little bit, and I don't want to hurt her feelings by choosing a sister. Yeah, I've got to make a decision.
We're not looking
Eve at... would like to stay with me,
I'd be happy about that.
Thank you very much,
Brendan.
Look after my sister.
Always.
Oh, I'm really happy. I might not have showed it initially, because I was still... Could you, everyone just see the terror on my face? Because then it was like first date mode then.
Enjoy yourself, be yourself, OK?
All right.
Thank you very much,
Thanks
Brendan.
For coming.
Yeah, no problem.
Cool. See you later.
Thanks.
Right, then.
You OK with that?
I'm perfect with that, Brendan.
Was that the right choice to make?
Yeah.
I thought so.
Of course he was the right choice. And I reckon that actually he really likes her. You know, I think she could be singing a bit of Dirty Dancing before the night's out.
Yeah, I reckon he's tangled both of them already. Have you seen the colour of them? Eh? They're like David Dickinson's daughters, the two of them.
Are you trying to suggest they're actually orange, Paddy?
Would I do that? Well, never. No, but they do look cheap as chips.
There we go.
And in this week's Coupling Up, it was time for one of the lads to get their hands on the other portion. God help them.
As Emma is new to Love Island, she will have first choice.
So we know who's picking, so.
Babe, it's easy, don't worry. It's all good.
You're on an open book at the moment, so I just want to get to know you more, OK?
Lovely.
OK?
And you're on an open book, and he'd like to open you.
She's chosen him. That's her choice. I have no rights on him. And to be honest, maybe she's done me a favour.
You stand out more, a lot more, to just, you know, because you've got a lot of depth, and I just think, yeah, I'd like to get to know you more.
Boys, we are about to choose our partners. Go, Lee!
Put your fag away, man.
Leo, then.
Bloody, you addict.
I wonder who's going to be.
I pick Colleen because I think she's really special. Oh. And she's really special to me.
Why, thank you.
I picked Sophie because we're getting on very well. And she's pretty sexy. And you never know.
I know, thank you.
Take your time. Tough choice.
Tough choice. Two
tough
beautiful,
choice.
Stunning women. My goodness. Baby.
No.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
I'm gonna choose you if that's okay.
Oh my God. I'm highly flattered.
I have chosen Kelly because I think Kelly is stunning. And actually, you just looked at me and there was just real beauty that came out and it actually kind of took my breath away.
Oh, wow.
Chris picking me was like shocked. I was like, wow. And his reason, I was like, are you serious? Yeah, I was very gobsmacked and flattered.
Let's give our commiserations and congratulations to our Bianca Gascoigne.
Thank you.
Are you happy with your coupling?
Yeah.
Did you not want to get to know anyone else? Or are you happy?
No, I would like a chance to get to know other people, but Lee and I are getting along really well.
Yeah.
So I'm totally fine with that.
Yeah.
It looks like we're going to be hitting it off now. So I couldn't be happier. I am living proof. If I pull this one off, I am living proof that the sun does shine on a dog's ass some days.
Baby, shall I move my shirts over?
No, you're not sleeping in the same bed as me.
Honey?
Darling, I can promise you, if you try and crawl into my bed, you will get kicked in the nuts so
Bring
hard.
The t-shirts over first. Come on, let's just see what it's like.
Coming up, Brendan puckers up. And Sophie's in despair.
Responsible is all I can say. F***ing irresponsible.
Welcome back to Love Island, where for yesterday's Daily Decider, the celebs were about to begin a fun little game. Oh, it was fun.
Oh, it was fun.
Guess your partner's weight.
Or as Sophie Anderson prefers to call it, does my strop look big in this?
Yes, Sophie, it does.
Dear celebrities, today's Daily Decider is called The Weigh-In. You have to each guess each other's weight.
So I'm not playing then.
Sorry,
guys. I don't
guys.
Even want to know my weight. That's used to be anorexic.
I've already fed it.
I felt for the girls because if I was in that position, I would have hated it.
I don't know, we've all put on weight in here, so I have a idea. And I don't want to know because I know I'm going to stop eating.
You've got an amazing figure.
It's not the point, baby. Anorexia is a disease, it's part of the addiction thing. Yeah. It's psychologically totally wrong.
I reckon I'm 11.
I'm about 9.5, 10. I've put on weight in here.
Okay, first up is Paul and Sophie. So if you could please just come on to the stage.
We can do it. It's just out for the day. Let's get out for the day.
Yeah, it just means I won't be eating for the next 3 weeks.
I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. But Paul, would you please guess Sophie's weight?
10 stone.
I haven't been weighed for 4 years. Irresponsible is all I can say. It's irresponsible.
Sorry, babe.
She's 9'6".
Okay. And Sophie, if you could just guess Paul's weight before he steps onto the scales, babe.
11.
11'3".
Okay, 11'3".
Come on, we're done.
Colleen first.
Yep.
I'm guessing about 8.5.
Okay, it's no big deal.
Okay, babe.
8'1".
Yeah. 8'1", okay.
So it's not that you're heavy.
That's heavy, in my eyes.
Honey, how tall are you?
Doesn't matter.
How tall?
Doesn't matter.
Colleen, sweetie, could you guess Lee's weight?
I'm gonna guess 9'10".
Okay, Lee, babe, if you could step up onto the scales.
9'11".
Well done. That was really good. Okay, so I'm confirming that is 6 pounds out.
Come on,
girl. Okay, Chris.
Yeah.
Could you please guess Kelly's weight?
8'7".
So that's 9 stone. Okay, Kelly, if you could please guess the lovely Chris's weight.
Stay still.
Okay.
Okay, that's all the way right. To do it, guys.
All right, I would say 12.
12 stone, yeah?
Oh, wow.
So that's 14 stone and 3 pounds. Shane, please, can you guess Emma's weight for me, sweetie?
I reckon 8 stone 3.
Okay, so you're going for 8 stone 3. Emma, could you please step up onto the scales, babe? Oh, 8 stone 4. That is an excellent guess. Emma, please, babe, could you guess Shane's weight?
13 stone.
13 stone. Okay, Shane, babe, would you please step up onto the scales? So we've got 12 stone 5 pounds.
That's good.
So we can clearly see who the winners are. And it is my lovely Colleen and Lee. Well done, babes. Yeah. Well done.
Yay.
Thank you, guys. Cheers.
Wow. All I wanted to do was go out today.
I don't really give a f*** about that. I'm slightly more worried about other things now.
I put on shitloads of work, mate, since I've been here.
Really? I put on 5 pounds.
I need a tape measure before I start getting paranoid. Bianca, if you go back up there, you better ask them for a tape measure, otherwise I'm going to be eating.
You're not going to be eating?
Yeah, they need to get me a tape measure so I can measure my measurements.
OK, do you want me to go and get you?
Yeah, they're going to have to. Mm-hmm. I need to make sure I'm 34, 24, 34, otherwise I'm
I don't know whether she cries, like, crazily because she just doesn't mind. I don't know, man. I don't get her sometimes.
I sympathise for the whole how she's feeling because it's not nice. Not nice to be upset, it's not nice to feel that way, but she never did it.
You're not forced to do anything you don't want to do.
It's not the point, they know me better than
that. Yeah, but you don't have to do anything, babe.
No, fail.
Stop putting yourself through things that you don't need to do.
Alright, dear. Alright, dear.
Good.
I love you
too. Muppet!
No.
I know it was all stupid and it's in my head, but obviously I've been modelling since I was 15. I was in Milan and Paris, I was a size 10 in those days, and I was told that I was too fat and this, that and the other. And so you have to understand, I was 15 years old. In the fashion industry, it's changed a lot, but it scarred me quite a lot. I've actually lost an inch of my hips. Now I feel a real idiot.
There you go.
No, there you go. Sorry.
I know.
No, you know, I just feel such an idiot. I should know myself. It's just I didn't want to fail and let Paul down. And I mean, I'm going to have to go and apologise. My tits have gone down, though.
Sophie's lost a bit off her bust, a bit off her hips. If she could just use a little bit of her ego, she'd be perfect.
Fern. So, she really has let herself go.
You were thinking it.
Yeah, she really has let herself go. You know, when your ego gets to that size, it's very hard to get down, isn't it, really?
It really is. Yeah. Now, meanwhile, Brendan was still hungry for love, and on their dream date, it was time for a woman called Eve to tempt him in the forest with her fruits.
But would Eve be tempted by his snake?
Eve, don't fall.
I pushed you, don't you, poor me, Brendan Cole.
Oh, my God. Day trip was just outstanding. We had to go on a trek down through the wilderness of Fiji, and we got down to the bottom of the stream, and there it was.
Oh no! I see wetsuits.
A big rock face, a massive waterfall, and a rope to climb up the waterfall. It was just like, wow.
Outfits perfectly, Brendan.
What they all say. Stop it, Eve.
Oh, this is harder than I thought.
Anyway, but then especially in front of someone that you know that you do like, and to do it so well was just amazing for me.
Okay, come on, baby. I'm all yours, baby.
Oh, come to Papa.
He's a gentleman, but then he's a bit goofy at the same time. To me, he's just so attractive because he's got so many different sides to him, and I like him even more now.
Such a thrill, I can't tell you. My heart was beating, I was like, exciting. So was Eve.
Eve can do it faster than me!
Oh, God. We enjoyed it so much, and we enjoyed it together. It was amazing.
Our reward at the top was a picnic. It was so romantic. You couldn't have wished for a more romantic setting.
Nice.
I like
it. It's funny how, you know, a day trip when you're out and you're together and you're bonding, it heightens your romantic feelings.
I have had such a fantastic day. Really, seriously, seriously. Every step of the way, I felt like you've been hugging her and kissing her.
Me too.
It's like, and it's not just because I've been here for 4 weeks.
Good.
And I'm going to find it hell tonight in the love shack. Let me just tell you that. Look, I've had an amazing day. And you look amazing. You look great. And you're not common, alright?
Thank
you. Don't ever say that again.
I won't.
I don't dig common chicks.
I know that I'm not his usual type. But I also think that there's definitely a spark there, you know, where you know that you could kind of even, like kiss someone and it would be reciprocated.
I was so nervous yesterday because I felt like I wasn't being myself. And every other thing that you did, I was like,
oh, oh really?
Yeah. I was like, all right, like maybe more.
Seriously?
Yeah.
I feel very self-conscious doing anything on camera, like even a kiss, like, Chris and Victoria had their first kiss on camera. Let's say you were to get together and you stayed together for years or marriage or kids or whatever, knowing your first kiss was in front of the nation on a television program to win a...
I totally agree. I don't even care if I'm making a fool of myself. I fancy Brendan a lot more after spending the day with him.
So, I'd be lying if I didn't say that wasn't a good
idea. Yeah.
Imagine your first kiss on national TV.
I know. So Brennan doesn't dig common chicks there, Paddy, which is just as well that he picked his sister Eve because she looks as common as muck. The other one, didn't she?
The other one, yeah. Yeah, they're like chalk and cheese, really, aren't they? Yeah. Not like at all.
I know. Well, Eve and Brendan are definitely hitting it off, but will Brendan be able to control himself in that love shack? Join us off the news to find out, plus this. Coming up on Love Island.
Really think I'd lower myself to those levels?
Sophie's had enough.
Maybe a model. I'm not dumb, though.
Lee's frustrated.
Not gonna wank.
And it's hotting up in the love shack.
Not gonna put him on the couch.
This girl's got class.
I'm sure we'll be sleeping in the same bed.
Oh, it's gonna be good. Turn over now to ITV2, where Matt and Jane are standing by with more After Sun, including an exclusive chat with lovely Bianca.
We will see you right after the news.
Bye-bye. Bye.